switch subjects a little bit, man. My girl Erykah Badu, man, she came on a little fire this week, you know.
Oh, man.
About her Hitler comments, but I get it. I see what she was saying. I think people got to read the whole context of the article, for one thing. From listening, watching social media, I'm like, y'all ain't hearing her. Basically, she was saying every evil person at one point had some type of spark of good in them. That's all she was saying. Let's break it down.
Like Erykah Badu did an interview with Vulture, and the interviewer was Jewish, and it was a good interview, by the way.
It was excellent interview.
And he asked a question regarding her trip to I think she was in Palestine. And I guess she had some type of involvement with Farrakhan.
Mr. Farrakhan, salute, respect.
Right, and then so people started labeling her as anti-Semitic. And then she said, I didn't even know what anti-Semitic was till they started accusing me of it, you know? So, but she was saying, yeah, I was just there to help the people.
Right.
And then basically she was saying she was a humanist, and there's good in everybody of some sort. And she said, even in Hitler. So that was part of the, and that was part of the outrage, because she's like, yeah, even Hitler was a, and she didn't say he was good as in he was morally good.
Right.
She said Hitler was a good painter.
Right.
And then people stopped right there, and when it was outraged about it, they didn't read the very next comment that she said. Because right after that interview, were like, no, he wasn't. He was a bad, he was a terrible
painter. But I heard he was a good painter. I don't really know, but I've seen little documentaries and stuff that say he dabbled in the painting.
Right, so she's like, okay, well, yeah, you're right. And then later on in the interview, like towards the end of the interview, she reiterated to him, like, I hope you're, did I offend you? He's Jewish now, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So he's like, no, but I was kind of like eerie about your comments, this, that, and the third, but he was cool. So, you know, so it wasn't like she was really trying to, like, be disrespectful or anything like that. But the greater point she was making was, we are told what to think,
right,
and we just run with it without questioning it. And she was saying she analyzed every situation differently on her own and comes to her own conclusions,
right,
which is what we should be doing.
Right.
You know? So, like, yeah. So even though Hitler did some very demonic, evil things, horrific things, he probably wasn't 100% pure evil either. You know, he probably loved his, you know, his team, you know what I mean, his friends or whatever the case may be, you know?
Right, right.
So, But it's so funny because I was seeing all the comments. I just hopped back on Twitter, the past couple of weeks, by the way.
Okay.
So you know, I ain't really been tweeting much. I just been kind of like just keep an eye on things, see what's going on.
Okay.
And of course, she was trending. So I'm reading the responses, and I'm reading, and I see black people going in on her, Jewish people going in on her, and I responded to a couple of Jewish people I saw in there, you know, because they really went in. I ain't really like that because I was just like, okay, I get it. Hitler's a sensitive subject, that he was evil, because of the Holocaust. And you know, he should be forever be demonized. I get that. But on the same note, I just feel like there's a double standard. Because I was like, look at America. They killed millions more of black people during the transatlantic slave trade. They killed millions more of Native Americans to take over the country. America's the only one that dropped nuclear weapons on ever. You know what I mean? On Japan, on Japanese civilians. Isn't that evil, too? You know what I mean?
Right.
So, but I don't see you calling America evil.
Right.
You know, and they got a lot more bodies than Hitler.
And speaking of, it's always the double standard because, you know, they cover their own bullshit. Let's keep it 100. Like, you're always hearing about the Holocaust, but what about, you know, Leopold II of Belgium? Because he wasn't no fucking king. Fuck him. You know, he killed damn near 10 million Africans, you know. But that ain't as equal as the Holocaust, but you don't hear about that. You know what I mean?
Right. Or if you mention it, or you mention slavery, they be the first one to tell you, get over it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's the problem that I have with it.
Right.
You know, like, be consistent across the board. Okay, yeah, Hitler is evil. I get that. Absolutely, I totally agree.
Right, right.
But at the same time, call out the bullshit on America, too.
Right,
you're not
going
to say that about America, because you get that American money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So who are you to put yourself on a higher, you know, more compass than anybody else because of that? You know? And I also was saying that, hell, Jewish people did some evil shit too. Like, It's no good and bad in war.
Right, right.
Everybody done something. It's a big gray area.
Right.
You know? So it's like don't make it seem like, so don't call out him and don't call out your own shit. Like, everybody has their own fucking dirt.
Right.
Everybody got dirt.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, and that's all I was saying. So, of course, they ain't like my comments at all.
They never do, boy.
They ain't want to hear none of that shit. But I'm like, yo, man, but don't come on here, don't come online and act like I had done no evil deeds at all in your whole history. Like, come on now.
Right.
You know, because, like, last time I checked, Palestine had nothing to do with putting the Jewish people in the Holocaust, but they the ones that are losing some land over it.
Right.
Explain that shit to
right.
me.
Right. I've never understood that either, too, and then you wonder why they fighting. That's just like, so, like, there's two people fighting across the street. And then they feel sorry for somebody and they come and put them in your house. What do you put them in my house for? Right. I ain't got nothing to do with it. Why don't you, like, so I never really got that.
Because it doesn't make any sense. Because you look at war, how war works. When you get reparations from the country that wronged you. You know what I mean?
Right.
So when
why ain't they get their own land in Germany?
Exactly. That's what they should have had. You know what I mean? Why did that happen?
Right.
Well, you know, we slick know the answer to that.
We're
not going to go into it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You ain't going to get into it, though. But, yeah, but, you know, but they don't want to hear that, though. Because, like, of course, go back to, like I'm always saying, they control the narrative. But Malcolm X is saying, you let the enemy teach your kids. And, you know, and I think that kind of disturbed me, too. It wasn't so much of the Jewish people going in on Erica. It was black people, too.
Right.
So it was like, yo, why you keep defending people who don't give a fuck about you? Like, and I said, did you not already forget who owns hip-hop? And what they've done to it? You know? But now you want to defend it now?
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yo, I mean, like, and I know, and like Erica said, I know it's an unpopular opinion. But I'm like, yo, I'm calling this shit out, man. Like, don't sit here and defend them. And these same people... You complain about it effing you over.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it was like, and really, I think we're the only people who do not own our own music.
Right.
We do not own our own genre. They got that shit, man. You know? So it's like, yo, man. So it's like, you know, we still don't get it, man. Like, and I hate to jump off topic, but same thing about the Women's March that just happened, too.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of black women was a part of that shit, too. I have a problem with that. Because, like, my thing, same thing with this whole movement. Like, these same women... But to say, talk about black lives don't matter.
Voted for Trump.
But you down, right? You know what I'm saying? But now you're rocking with them in the march. And then my thing is, okay, you fighting for them and their rights, but where were they?
When you needed
when
yours.
Sandra Bland was in trouble. Where were they when the missing girls in D.C.? You know what I'm saying? I never seen any white woman speak out against all that shit. You know? But yeah, but yeah, we jumping on to their bandwagon. You know? So I rock with Erykah, man. Like, we gotta think critically for ourselves and look at, you know, we gotta zoom out and look at the overall playing field.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because we so quick to hop on people's bandwagons, but nobody taking up for us.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, like, you know, so I have a problem. So I hit it from that angle, too. So, you know, yeah, but I decided it was interesting, man. And Erykah Badu, man, like, I bet she could do nothing but smile just watching everything unfold online. Like, y'all just confirmed everything she was just fucking saying in the interview.
Right.
Y'all are group thinkers, you know?
Right.
And, like, it's so scary that we live in an age of information. We have information at our disposals now, and we don't even read the shit.
Right.
We just read the damn headline.
Right.
And run with it, you know?
Right.
So, it's like, man. But yeah, man. Like, yeah, people came at me, bro. Like, I thought I was about to get banned.